grade 8. Today, we will study Unit 32, the Light Verses, or Surat An-Nur, from verse 35 to verse 40. But before heading to the explanation or the interpretation of these verses, we should listen to the reciting of these verses.
الله نور السماوات والأرض مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله كل شيء عليم في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم والله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب والذين كفروا أعمالهم كسراب كسراب يحسبه الظمآن ماء حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا ووجد الله عنده فوفاه حسابه والله سريع الحساب أو كظلمات في بحر يغشاه موج من فوقه موج سحاب ظلمات بعضها فوق بعض إذا أخرج يده لم يكد يراها ومن لم يجعل الله له نورا فما له من نور.
So now we will move to the explanation of each verse, starting from verse 35. Allah is the light of the heavens and earth. The likeness of this light is a niche, wherein is a lamp. The lamp is in a globe of glass. The globe of glass, as it were a brilliant star, kindled from a blessed tree. An olive that is neither of the west of the east nor of the west, whose oil well lit will not light up even if no fire touched it. Light upon light, Allah guides to his light whomever he wills, and Allah gives examples for men, and Allah has knowledge of everything. So, verse 36, this light is now lit in the houses of worship, which Allah has enjoined to be raised, wherein his name is remembered. In them they glorify him in the mornings and the evenings. Verse 37, by men who are not distracted by trade or commerce from the remembrance of Allah, the performance of prayers, and the giving of the purifying duties as zakah, they fear a day on which hearts and eyes will be agitated. Verse 38, so that Allah may give them the best reward for their deeds and grant them even more out of his bounty, and Allah provides without measure to whomever he wills. Verse 39, as for those who deny the truth, اللي بيكذبوا بالحقيقة أو بالقرآن, their deeds are like a mirage, كسراب in a desert, في الصحراء, which the thirsty man thinks to be water until he comes to it and finds nothing there. But he finds Allah near him, who then pays him his account. And Allah is swift at reckoning. Verse 40, or their deeds are like thick darkness in a vast and deep sea, which waves cover, over which there are other waves, above which are clouds, layers of darkness, one upon another. When he holds out his hand, he can hardly see it. And whomever Allah gives no light has no light at all. Now we will move to the general explanation of these verses or this chapter, which is the most important thing in our lesson. So Allah's light in the Muslim's heart. Verse 35. Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. The light verses form some of the countless most prized and brilliant passages of the Quran. Speaking of the literary charm of the glorious Quran and taking this particular verse as a specimen, an English lady, now happily a Muslim, says, it's impossible to give a translation that can convey the poetry, the subtle meaning that floods the soul when read in the original. To me, grandeur of the diction, the varieties of the imageries, and the splendor of the wood painting differentiates the Quran from all other scriptures. Lady Coppert, Pilgrimage to Mecca, quoted in Tafsir Majidi, هذا اسم الكتاب. So Ibn Abbas radiallahu anh said that the word Nur alludes to Allah's guidance, أي تشير إلى Allah's guidance, found in every believer's heart. Some other Quran scholars believe that it's the Nur or the light of the Quran. Allah Most High has named his book Nur, وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا مُبِينًا. Verse 36, this light is now lit in the houses of worship, which Allah has enjoined to be raised, wherein his name is remembered. In them they glorify him in the mornings and evenings. So, in houses Allah has enjoined to be raised up, the word raised up may be understood in the concrete sense of set up, meaning house of worship built especially for the constant remembrance of Allah, a house ennobled by the constant remembrance of Allah. Verse 37. Men who are not distracted. This refers to people whose worldly occupations do not distract them from constant and complete devotion to Allah. verse 38 is self-explanatory. أي إنه الآية شارحة نفسها ما لا تحتاج it doesn't need any explanations. So verse 39. By the word deeds is meant the good deeds of the disbelievers who reject the truth. They look bright here, in this life, but would be worthless in the hereafter. أي أن الكفار مهما فعلوا من أعمال حسنة سوف يكون ليس لها أي قيمة في أو يوم القيامة. They are bound to realize on the day of judgment that all their supposedly good deeds have been rendered worthless by their deliberate refusal to listen to the voices of truth. So the last verse is verse 40. Or their deeds are like thick darkness. This again refers to the deeds of the deniers of the truth, who refuse to acknowledge the source of all beings. Ubay ibn Ka'b once remarked that the example is that of the disbelievers who live in a fivefold darkness of speech, deed, entry, exit, and the destination into the fire, based on Tafsir ibn Kathir. So now we finished our lesson for today, and inshallah in the next class we will answer the questions of this unit. Try to answer the questions by your own selves, but inshallah I will send you the answers in the next class. Wish you the best.